can you take this picture?
Where people what?
People like this, this.
Okay.
Can you take this picture? This race?
Yeah, that race.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But just in this way, that
the people is going to. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but you don't need to take this.
Okay.
But this is Bozer.
Ah, okay.
Interrupt.
okay.
No, moving.
Yeah, moving.
And next on the track, we're going to do the heats on the women's 200 meters.
Chuck.
We have 7 heats, first 3 in each. And the next 3 fastest advancing to the semifinals, those can be run at 18:10 this evening.
Now, you should take a part.
Huh?
Carlos on the scoreboard in lane 1, the World Championship finalist for Great Britain last year, Shannon Hilton. And in lane 2, last year's World
Championship. So, do you want to record the
sixth of the 100 here, Irena Applewood.
Yeah.
This is heat 1.
You can see it. It's
200 meters.
No, because if I see it, it's like.
Welcome.
Ah.
I can't go for it. I can't say go for it to her. Grandma.
Is that okay? Is this okay? It's
yeah, really okay, short. Okay, yeah. Mm.
Yeah, he's ready. Yo!
Oh, nervous! He's so bozer! Bozer!
No! Bozer Kenna! Okay, thanks.
Yeah, thanks.
From inside, Hilton Echo, Shaboda, Tsuchihashi, Shakibuba, Baron, Tsuchihashi, and Shore.
Tsuchihashi.
In lane 4, Tsuchihashi. And in lane 1, Hilton. And then Eglin. Hilton and Eglin on the outside, George. And now it's Eglin. Eglin going around Wisconsin. Sakanashi of Japan.
Sakanashi!
So it's now Hansen, Sakanashi, and Holmes. Hansen and Holmes.
On the other side of the door, so he sees on his way into his room. That'd be better. It's closer to the time that he needs to take them. They probably don't want signs on the doors, though. On the hallway side. Should have washed my hair. I have an itchy head today.
Well, he was doing good. He was out of his Zydeco, so I had to fill that.
You taking picture of American roads?
Yeah. To see what's the difference between our streets, our roads, and user roads.
These are very different.
Yeah, some kind of. I don't know. It's more. It they have more space, they are more wide.
These are?
These.
Yeah.
Everything is more...
Well, we have big, fat American cars, you know. For big, fat Americans.
I don't think...
So we have big, fat roads.
Well, we had cars earlier in this country than you probably had in your country. We just... Infrastructure to make roads to accommodate traffic.
Mm. Well, we had engineering, a lot more engineering than Central America.
Yeah. I don't think these American cars could fit in our streets, in our roads. Too much, I think. So.
Well, Europe, you know, has real narrow little roads because it's so old that it was built at a time where they didn't make much roads, so they're not going to move all
horses.
The buildings to make the roads wider, so the roads are be really narrow in a lot of the towns.
Probably would have many more people on the street walking on Sunday morning. People with bicycle walking and carrying things, and maybe mules and maybe carts.
Probably a lot more motorcycles. You have a lot of motorcycles.
Motorcycles.
Moped.
Motorbikes. A lot of those.
Well, I don't think so. We have more cars than motorcycles.
Oh, really?
So, and in my country, we have a law, a kind of law, called Piquiplaca. I cannot translate it into English, but some days the government classified some cars by the final character of the car.
The license plate number. You know, you have a number on the back of the car.
Yeah.
Square plate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, by the last character of that, of the number of the car, some days you cannot drive a car between some hours for avoid traffic. So, for example, in Monday, if you have a car number ending in 7, and Monday is forbidden 7, so you cannot drive your car.
Yeah.
Because it ends on 7.
We had that in the 70s.
With gas rationing.
We had trouble getting gas from Saudi Arabia in the 70s, so we had gas rationing. So we could only go to gas station one day a week if our license number was the correct number. Same thing.
Mm-hmm.
We rationed. You know what ration means?
Ration.
It means not give out some product to you. Rationing, so you can only, like during the war, you can only buy certain things, no metal products, no rubber products, because it was all to build warships and airplanes and rubber for airplane industry, industrial needs for building all of the things for our war to defeat Germany and Japan. So. During the 40s in America, you couldn't go to the store and buy tires. You couldn't go buy anything with metal, aluminum especially. So it was all rationed. It means the government stopped you from buying it. And food was rationed also. So much food had to go to the military to feed the soldiers.
Wow.
So we know about rationing in this country. But the word rationing is maybe foreign to you. Not able to buy something when you want it, only on a specific day because of the number you have.
Yeah.
License. You have ration cards in our wallet, you know, to buy food. and ration cards to buy tires. Well, you couldn't buy tires, period. Mm-hmm. So you'd have to wear out old tires.
There she is.
You're looking very beautiful today.
Thank you so much.
More than usual.
Hi.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Byron.
Hi, from Byron.
From Ecuador.
And your name?
Justine.
Justine?
Yes.
Ah.
He's taking pictures of American roads today because in Ecuador, they're very different than Ecuador. So he's going to show his family and friends all about American culture. You can make video. Make a complete video someday from cell phone.
I would like to do it, but this kind, this thing is battery, like...
Vibrate.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah,
the battery.
You're looking so many.
The battery is very, very, very short, so the duration.
Okay.
I'm sure there's time to
you have good English. Duration, vibrate, those are unusual words. Japanese would not know those words.
I just practiced my English, what I heard before. I was talking with Derek about the black slang because...
About what?
Black slang is like the accent of the black people in the USA.
Oh yeah, black slang.
Yeah,
yes.
So it's just like, it's like I like them to talk. But
you like?
Yeah, but when I arrived in Oregon and I saw black people, they don't talk with that accent. What's happening?
Well, you have to go to the inner city. Blacks have a very distinct slang.
Yeah.
And then blacks out in the country, in the South, where the many blacks live in the South, part of America, they have a very distinct accent that's different than the city blacks. So you have to talk about what slang you like. City black, inner neighborhood.
It kind of depends on where they're
it's
raised.
It's like drugs and homies. And
yeah, homies, yeah.
Low-rider cars with fancy wheels.
Yeah.
That's all the black drug culture slang. And then there's blacks from the South. And then there's middle class blacks that live in our society that are like teachers in schools and library professors in this university professors. They talk like us because they're educated.
Mm-hmm. So the black slang is like for street accent.
The street accent, street culture black. Then there's intelligence, go to college, white middle class tile black speech. Then there is black southern speech, because the blacks all came from the South. They brought them over on slave boats to work in cotton fields, cotton and sugar fields during the Civil War, 1800s. By the millions, so blacks all came to the West from the East, where their grandparents and great-grandparents were slaves.
We
had a very huge slave economy in the 1700s and 1800s in America. It was 80% of our gross national product or economy was due to slave labor.
You know, I
could walk in America. It was exporting cotton to England, France, to make clothing. Millions upon millions and millions of big bales of cotton were shipped over on ships to England from southern ports, Charleston, South Carolina, Georgia. All those southern states had millions of slaves picking cotton and making cotton and selling it to Europe. That's where the American economy was, and tobacco and sugar, cane sugar plantations in Louisiana. Many, many millions of slaves. And much money was earned from free slave labor. So they would put slaves up in the shacks, little terrible little chicken houses, and treat them very poorly, feed them poorly, and make them work.
I love it.
When the sun comes up until the sun goes down, they made the slaves work.
Right. Right.
Very hard.
Well, I'll tell you, I'm really glad that I got to.
Yeah, I think it was something like that. We are actually reading a book called Nelson Mandela, and that's for my reading, writing, grammar class. So we actually we are in the fourth chapter, and they say that the South Africans were treated very, very badly in their own country because there was white people inside the South Africa,
yeah.
And they were very unfair treated.
Yeah, they were colonized
by
the white, the European, and whatever the white colonialists, the British, French, and American would colonize all over, like. You know the word colonize?
Yeah, the colonize. Like you.
The colony. You're
we
part
own
of us,
us
now.
Yeah.
We own you, and you are a slave, or you are lower in society.
And you have to do everything we. And we have to. You have to do everything I told you, or something. Yeah.
Well, that same thing. Same concept, mindset was the slave. The slave trade. The slaves were also brought to Jamaica, Caribbean islands. They'd bring slaves there from Africa and then sell them to whoever would buy them.
Yeah.
Mostly planters, millionaire planters in the South would buy them and then ship them up to their plantations to work in this. Hey, but look at there's a Karlak bronze. Yeah, Ron, my brother has one of those.
Yeah. Oh yeah, no, those are great.
With a white top.
Yeah.
But very shiny, not like that.
Yeah.
Bronze is like showroom.
Yeah, it would be. But anyway, it was an interesting story. I got it on Audible and listened to it. And so I owe him an email telling him what
I did. I didn't know that here in Oregon, all the sky has no clouds most of the summer. Time.
Yeah. We have like 2 months like this, no cloud, starting in July, August. So this is average normal weather now for the next 2 months. And August is the hottest month. It'll get up to 100, 104 next month. Like Ecuador, but not humid. More dry heat, not moist heat, so it's not so bad.
I don't really contact Peter, and his mother did something really, really awful. She told me and another mutual friend of ours that Peter was not their natural son, that he was adopted during the war. And he's very dark, and he has a military temperament. What do you think? Who occupied Denmark in the 40s, early 40s? Germany. Yes, he's a German baby.
So Germany occupied Denmark in the 40s?
Yes. For about 3 years. And Denmark was the only country that rescued their Jews.
Wow. Oh.
And I got to know some families who were part of the Underground Railroad getting them out.
So Danish, did they have a lot of Danish Jews that they got out of Denmark before the Nazis?
Well, there was a flotilla of boats getting them to Sweden, which was neutral.
Was this what?
They floated them over in boats to Sweden.
Okay, because it was neutral.
Yes.
Well, we had boats full of them coming to America, but they turned them back.
Yes, I know.
Came to New York, and I mean thousands of them, and they had to go back to where they came from, and they'd be going to the concentration camps.
Oh, yeah.
It's one of the worst things that's ever happened. We could have given them, you know,
sanctuary.
And
well, look what they're doing to the immigrants right now down in, you know, Texas and Arizona.
They're shooting them.
No, they're
killing some of them that are trying to get over. Some of the really bad police are doing that. Not
but
as
anyway,
a matter of
so,
course.
Peter's mother said that we were never to kill Peter. Isn't that too much of a burden?
Yeah.
You know, that shouldn't have been imposed upon us. I'm sorry.
We are at church at 11:45. Run up the flag and the band can start playing, actually early.
Faith Center.
Faith Center. This is it. We didn't bring our bottles and cans, but we're not a pot drinking bunch. That stuff's poison.
What's poison?
Pot.
Oh, it is.
Corn sugar.
It is.
And the diet stuff's even worse.
Mm-hmm.
It's addictive and it kills your body, but people love it. They think it's the best thing since sliced bread.
Hey, look at, there's a spot there.
We can park right there. I'm going to back up right next to that little white Mini Cooper, that little blue Mini Cooper.
Hey, I remember them.
Yeah, they were at the...
And the fireworks.
Yeah, you'll see lots of friends.
Surely.
The people that own the house we were at are here. The Emersons, the family that... But their girls, their kids go to church somewhere else.
Got tipped over after it was lit.
They might be here today.
And they're shooting outside.
Yeah, a big mortar, big firework.
Oh, that's dangerous. It's really loud.
Yeah,
so
Zeke didn't like it. Zeke stayed in the house the whole time.
But it was still rolling it out everywhere.